Let's do this.
What's poppin'? Brand new whip, just hopped in. I got options. I can pass that bitch like stock.
It's a beautiful morning to chat NBA, and we're talking next generation.
That next wave of leaders of the NBA.
Guys that are electrifying.
Jaylen Brown with the finish!
My swag, they keep jacking. I ain't doing no verse, quit asking.
Goes to count it and one.
It's amazing how things are shifting, and they're dangerous every night.
I believe the game is in good hands.
My body got rid of them toxins. Sports in the top 10.
Yeah, right now I got like an adrenaline rush. Like I'm watching Steph Curry warm up, I'm watching Andre Iguodala warm up. It's almost unreal. Like it's a great feeling. I can't wait to see the finals. One day I want to be in the same situation as this guy.
I want to get here so bad. I will be here.
Being at the game in 2016, getting to watch the NBA finals where I said as a 18-year-old, like one day I'm gonna be here. I don't think it was a coincidence at all that 6 years to the day of 2016, and I was exactly in the place that I said I would be in.
Welcome to Chase Center in San Francisco.
Jaylen Brown making his first NBA Finals appearance.
Position of Brown with a head of steam and says it with his chest at the other end.
With a three, it's up and good. He's got 20.
Tatum to Brown the block.
Back out to Jordan, reload three, and he got it.
Tatum, a Euro step Curry from way downtown.
The Golden State Warriors once again our NBA champions in 2022.
One day I'll be here in this final.
I wish I would have said I was gonna win it, because then that would have worked out a little bit better for me. Losing in the finals drove me all summer to take my game to a different level, my body, to another level, my mind, to another level, just driving me on all cylinders just to be better. You get to a point where you feel like when you come up short, it only makes you hungrier for the next moment. I can be what the game needs me to be. At times I can be, you know, water.
So deep in its bag.
And then at times I can be fire. In one way, I think that I have an edge on opponents. I think how I play, you know, why I play. And those who recognize my spirit know that, you know, I'm not gonna back down. I'm here for a reason. Sports is like the most influential thing in our society besides maybe music, you know? So being able to use that platform is super important. There's different places in the world you can learn from, different cultures, different religions, different ways of life, different belief systems, and being able to travel and experience them and meet the people there helps expand your mind.
When you're growing up and you only see things one way, when you finally get to see it another way, it makes you question, you know, if the way you've been seeing it is the right way to see it.
Faith, consistency, hard work pays off. I started writing that on my shoes when I was like 14 years old. It's almost like a mantra. Those are things that I believe if you put into whatever craft, whatever discipline that you are involved with, it'll carry you to where you want to go. It represents a mentality. It represents an energy that I think not just applies to basketball, you know, it applies to life.
Got some sad breaking news to tell you about. Boston Celtics legend Bill Russell has died.
Remembering the life of NBA great and activist Bill Russell. He died at the age of 88.
It is a sad day for all of New England. Bill Russell meant so much to the city. Gonna miss him, no question about it. Gonna miss this man.
Bill Russell was a great man.
But what did that mean? What defined his greatness? Who he was as a mentor, a father, a member of his community, most certainly his 11 championships here in Boston, both playing and coaching. Bill Russell was a great man for what and who he stood for.
Do you think that you will get some white kids to play basketball with Negro kids?
I think so. I don't see why not. My kids are playing with white kids, and nobody got hurt yet.
He was a true champion, both on and off the floor, and our gratitude is endless. May he rest in peace.
And I don't even think people really truly understand what he had to persevere through and who he was and what he represented. A lot of people disliked him for what he stood for and what he stood up for. But in time, you know, people realized who Bill Russell was. They realized what his spirit represented. They realized, you know, what type of human being he was. He was elegant as well as strong. He was unafraid. He was one of the best examples of an athlete slash human being that I think you can find. And I feel like a part of me has that same calling.
First and foremost, I'm a black man, and I'm a member of this community, and I grew up on this soil, so I want to say that first and foremost, but it's a peaceful protest, we walking, and that's it.
I want to use my platform to speak for people who don't necessarily get to be heard, and I think that Bill Russell, doing it in a city like Boston and doing it here, and then fast forward to me being here, I think there's a lot of, you know, synergy. Being an athlete is not about, you know, the money, the cars, or, you know, just listening to what people tell you to do. We have an influence in our community. We have a voice. We come from certain parts of America that people like to hide. And I feel like I escaped the barriers that were put up in society to not allow me to be here. But that doesn't mean I'm any different from these kids in my neighborhood. I just like to remind people that. Muhammad Ali, Jim Brown, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, they walked a path that a lot of people have not traveled to make this world, you know, a better place to stand up for black and brown people in our country, in our society. And I commend them for it. You know, I think that I'm one of those people as well. We got a special team this year. We're balling right now. We got a good group of guys that play the game the right way. We got experience, we got youth, we got talent. Right now, it's just fun. But when that adversity hits, that's when you get to see what a man is really made of.
Aaron, get out. Red.
So those are the moments that I live for. Those are the moments where you get people together and get everybody on the same page and be like, look, this is what it takes. This is what we need. No excuses.
Hello. Oh, there we go. Can everybody hear me? Well, first of all, welcome everybody to the second annual Juice Foundation Gala. Before we get started, though, we want to bring up the man of the hour. Please give it up for the one and only Jaylen Brown.
Appreciate everybody for coming out today. And I think that it's important that we include diversity, equity, and inclusion into spaces. And, you know, the room that we in is an embodiment of that. So I'm excited to get the night started. I'm grateful. So thank you guys for coming. My main focus and motivation is the next generation, just being able to be a role model or to push you know, our youth forward, you know, in terms to make this world a better, more equal, more diverse place. I think that we have a lot of work to do in our education system, in our healthcare system, in our wealth disparity, in our incarceration rate. All of these things need to be addressed loudly.
He stands for excellence, he stands for commitment, he stands for belief in change. He's inspiring, and we're thrilled that he lives in our city.
What up, my boy?
What's up, man? I appreciate you stopping by, dog.
You know it. That's love. You look good, too. You're like African king.
You know, brother.
One more shout out. In the midst of, you know, competition and controversy, you know, a lot of times, you know, athletes, we get caught up in going against, you know, our opponents, you know, so it's great to see not only my teammates, but also see two my brothers from the Miami Heat here who are not that attractive. Yeah, I appreciate them guys for showing up for sure.
I've always felt like God has put me in this position because he wanted me to make a difference. I'm one of the people that thinks society has a lot of growing and a lot of work to do and a lot of healing. Sometimes it gets people uncomfortable, but sometimes uncomfortable is okay, because when you're uncomfortable, that's when growth happens.
Thank you all for coming. A lot of work to still be done, so keep that in mind. Thank you guys. Boom.
Back at the Garden, where tonight the Celtics close out an historic homestand.
We may be in store for one of those typical Miami-Boston games that we know and love so well.
Miami, tough team, well coached, good organization. They have a style of ball they want to play, and no matter who they put on the floor, they're going to compete. My mindset when I step on the court is just control what you can control and just be the best version of you, and that's what I focus on. So I have full belief, full faith in myself. So I just come out and play with confidence and play free and be the best version of Jaylen that I can be. Competitiveness inside of me that I love, you know, big games. I love going against the best.
Brown off the dribble.
I put the time in the mat. I put the team on my back.
Gets it back. Hard with the left-handed dribble, puts it up and in. Oh my goodness.
And Jaylen carrying the mail tonight. He's got 12. Butler drives, goes to the right hand, runs it up and in, score to the foul.
And the Celtics will hold a three-point lead at the half.
Let's go, baby!
Turnover, Boston. Here comes Bam. White fouls him. He still made the bucket.
Brown to the basket. Yes.
Jimmy Butler's got it. Take a very tough ball away, and he hits it.
And it might be the end of the game.
Smart has it in his hands. No timeout. Holding it. Gets it into Jaylen.
Brown takes it.
Fires a long three.
Oh!
And he banked it in! Jaylen Brown, 8 feet behind the three-point line.
And the bank is open Friday night.
We are finding our way to overtime. Jimmy Butler comes back to Boston and does it again. And the Celtics suffer just their fifth loss of the year. The final score, Miami 120, Boston 116.
I think everything is a learning experience. I think as we continue to move through the season, we just got to take every game, you know, for what it's worth and learn from it and move forward. Thank you. The star power, I think, has increased. And you get to see it all across the league. I feel like I still haven't gotten the respect that I think I deserve.
Sweet move from Jaylen Brown.
But even to be, you know, where I'm at now, I'm blessed and grateful. It's just a blessing to be able to come out and play each and every night.